Hi guys, my name is Peter and welcome to our channel. Today I was gonna clean a brake pads and a brake disc on our bicycle MX370. It's pretty good bicycle, but like most bicycles with disc brakes, time to time they start squeaking. And it's squeaking not because the brake pads is dry. It's squeaking because the brake pads and disc is dirty. I mean, to clean that, we will need some cleaning solution. You can use a brake pads cleaner, and pretty much a lot of people do that. Just spray it. It will take care of that problem, maybe for, I don't know, for some short time, but eventually it will start squeaking again. Don't use, because I know some people do that, DW40, that's a bad recipe. DW40 is not meant to be to clean it. It's lubricate and it can work as a lubrication also. It will break it, some rust crap a little bit. I mean, break it some rusted bolt and nuts. Not cleaning disc pad. What usually I do to make sure it will last longer, I use lacquer or acetone, disassemble it and clean it pretty good. And that way it will take care of the problem for a long, long time. And the brake pads, caliper, there's a couple options how you can take it. The brake caliper itself with those two bolts, but then you will have to realign it. Or brake caliper with support with those two bolts. And I usually, especially if brake pads doesn't have to be realigned, I mean readjusted, usually I take those two bolts and I take a caliper with support in a one piece. You need an Allen wrench set. Then we're gonna unscrew those couple bolts. It's straightforward. It's a 6mm bolts. Even this bicycle doesn't have too much mileage. It has probably 250, 200 or so. Yeah, around 200 plus, I should call. It's pretty good, pretty nice, clean. Let's see. We're gonna remove it. Brake pads. At least one by one. Then I'm gonna pour it a little bit amount of lacquer thinner. You have to be a little bit careful to make sure you're not gonna spit anything. And cleaning like that. You can also clean the backside, then wipe it, and I'm gonna show you. Usually the dirty pads, when it starts squeaking already, you take them out and they kind of dusty and dirty. Now when you clean it, you can see, I mean, all little particle of pads, and this pad is pretty good. It has a copper pieces inside. It usually lasts pretty good. Now, I mean, you can. Usually, how I do, I'm gonna remember it which one in or out. I take it one pad, put it, and then remove it second one. And let's clean it. Even it doesn't have too much dirt, I clean it a couple months ago or so, but it starts squeaking a little bit again, slightly. More than that. And the same thing. Clean it to make sure it's nice and clean. No greasy stuff, no dirt, anything. Some people asked me already before, a friend of mine, why pads is squeaking on bicycle more than on a car. On a car, very rarely when the brake pads is squeaking. On a bicycle, it's quite often. The thing is, that's the way how I clean the rotor itself. Yeah, and you can see the rock, it's kind of dirty. Anyway, on a car, because the pad, the brake pads, brake caliper assembly, it sits behind, inside the wheel. And when you're driving, it's less chance to get some crap and dirt on the pad itself. It actually do that, I mean, it gets. But still, I mean, the brake pads, it's much bigger. On a bicycle, everything is exposed. I mean, especially when on a smaller bicycle, tires, it has a more problem than on a bigger tires, because it's lower to the ground. You get into puddle, it will splash it. Some kind of crap on a road, it will get on a brake, a rotor and path. And you just put it the same way as was before. That's it. If you need alignment, not alignment, adjust it. For example, your path has a lot of mileage, start getting thinner, because those paths, you can tell, it's almost brand new. Like I said, it still have 3 millimeters thick or so. But on my scooter, the brake pads, it's getting much thinner, and I have to adjust it, because when you apply it brakes, you see, it only push it one pad. The other pad push it in, but not this one. This one is stationary, and how you adjust it, pretty much with another Allen wrench, you turn it, that screw in or out, and that's how it brings the pad in closer to the disc brake or farther. On some calipers, this caliper I don't see it, but some calipers has a small set screw to secure it, that big screw. If that's the case, loosen up first small screw and adjust it, and then tighten the set screw. Well, put it back in the straight forward, same way as you take it before. Using those 6 millimeter couple screw which you removed when you was taking apart. Now you put in back together. And like I said, this way, one thing is better, especially if you don't have to readjust the brake pad. Of course, when you tighten everything back, make sure those bolts nice and tight. Don't over-tight, because the support itself and the caliper, it's aluminum. It's easy to strip it. But tighten it enough. Then, of course, you have to use make sure the brake is work functionally. And then when you raise it, spin it, the brakes, if they didn't grab it before, if it didn't touch it before rotor, when you assemble it, everything back together, it will not grab, it will not mess alignment. If you take those two screws, then you will have to realign it, caliper itself, to make sure it has your wheels, it spins nice and free. Well, guys, that's a short video. I hope it's gonna be useful for someone. I hope you guys did enjoy it. If you do, thumbs up. If you don't want to miss any future videos, subscribe. We will really appreciate it. Thank you, and bye-bye.